Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about the lesson number 1.3 autobiography of great Indian bustard of standard 6. So in last lesson you have learned about the 1.2 lesson, who is the greatest. Already we have completed the answer question of that lesson. And today we are going to learn about the great Indian bustard. Why the bustard, that the particular bird has got is a great Indian bustard, that thing we are going to learn from this lesson. Very first we have to understand what is the autobiography, because the word is, means the title of the lesson is autobiography of the great Indian bustard. So autobiography means that the person who write his own event, life event, it is called as the autobiography. So in this lesson, that bustard has mentioned different kinds of his own life, how he survived in the environment, how he, where he lived, which kind of the food he eat, etc. Many things he has mentioned in this lesson. And by his different kinds of the his quality and his work, he is called as the great Indian bustard. So let us see details by the textbook. Page number 6. Let's see in your textbook. I am going to read the first passage. Very first sentence is written over there. Which is the heaviest flying bird in India? So that is the question for everyone of you. So you can tell that answer. Many birds are there which just they fly very high in the sky. So that first sentence, means first question, is given by the bustard. Which is the heaviest flying bird in the India? Well friends, it's me. Means that bustard is telling to you. Bustard is telling to you by asking that the question, which is the heaviest flying bird in India? So he is telling that the answer, none other than it's a bustard. So the great Indian bustard, I feel proud to be known as the great Indian bustard. So he says that when the people say that he is the great Indian bustard, that time he feel very proud, because obviously it's a very good thing to everyone. Suppose someone is calling to you, you are the great Indian, you are the great person, you are the brilliant, you are the smart, you are etc. So whenever we, the people, appreciate to us like that the sentence, by listening that the sentence, we become very happy, we become very delighted. So same here, when the people call to the bustard as a great Indian bustard, at that time he become very happy, he feel very proud by that the sentence. I have more than 30 different names in various Indian languages. So one more thing is here, Indian bustard, not only this is the name of bustard, but also 30 more than names are in the different languages about the bustard. So let's see which are given for bustard, the different name. In Marathi, I am known as the Maldo or whom. I can weigh up to the 18 kilos and can stand up to the 4 feet in height. So that bustard is called in Marathi as the Maldo or the whom. This is the name of the bustard in the Marathi language. And more one information is given by the bustard here. Which is, so he can weigh up 18 kilos, means 18 kilos weigh he can be up, and he can stand up to the 4 feet high height, reaching up to the shoulder or even higher. I have got a long white neck, brown wings, tall yellow legs, and a black cap on my head. So this is the description, this is the information about the bustard. He has mentioned himself, how he look, how he can be fly, how he can be stand on the earth. Means that all the information he has mentioned in this first stanza. So in this first stanza, we have learned about that why the bustard is called as the great Indian bustard. His name is Marathi in the Maldo or the whom. He can be weigh up to the, he can weigh nearly 18 kilo, and he can stand up to the 4 feet height. Even his neck is the white, and many things means how is the wing, how which color of the wings are there, many things he has mentioned here in the first stanza about the description of himself. Again, My wife Mrs. Bustard is smaller and slimmer than I am, and her neck is not white, but I have heard humans say what we both look impressive. So here is mentioned, he has mentioned about his Mrs. Mrs. Bustard. She looks smaller than the Bustard. She is a slimmer than the Bustard, and his neck is not white, because Bustard in first stanza he has mentioned, sorry, first passage he has mentioned his neck is white, but he now mentioned about the Mrs. His Mrs. is slimmer than him, and his neck is not white like that the Bustard. But I have heard human says that we both look impressive. So what is the meaning of impressive? That means humans, means the people say that means Mrs. and Mr. Bustard, both they look very impressive, very attractive, very decorative. So that impressive means attractive, because if you look to them, because now the digital board is not working, otherwise I may be able to show you. But in fact, you can see in your textbook page number 6 already 3 pictures are given for you. In that pictures, you can see that the picture of Bustard, which is looking very beautiful. Means Bustard want to tell you that the people say to the Bustard, both Mrs. and Mr., they are very impressive, they are very decorative.